let us find the time complexity of this quicksort in case of best case. Fine. So we have this following recursive relation. So either you can solve this recursive relation using the master's theorem, or here I am going to follow the long procedure, which is the back substitution method. Okay. So let us see. We have Tn is equal to 2t n by 2 plus n. That means the time taken to solve n data item, the time taken to sort n data items, then that will be equal to 2 into time taken to sort n by 2 data items plus order of n for partitioning procedure. Okay. So here we have t n by 2. Right. So let us find what is the value of t n by 2. So t n by 2 will be equal to, in every case n, just put the value n by 2. So we are going to get 2 into t n by 2 by 2 plus n by 2, which is equal to 2t n by 2 square plus n by 2. This is the value of t n by 2. Now put this value here. So we are going to get t n is equal to 2 into 2t n by 2 square plus n by 2 plus n. So again this value will become 2 square t n by 2 square plus n plus n. Okay, so this n plus n can be written as 2n. Fine. So this value will be, again find the value of t n by 2 square. So if you find this value, you can find out it is 2 square into 2t n by 2 cube plus n by 2 square plus 2n. Again this 2 will be multiplied here, therefore it will become 2 cube t n by 2 cube plus n plus 2n, which is equal to again 3n. So this will be 2 cube t n by 2 cube plus 3n. Fine. Now if you extend this up to some point of time, you can say it is tn is equal to 2 raised to power k t n upon by 2 raised to power k plus kn. Okay, so you can extend it to some time. Okay, now assume we have only one single data items. Just to sort one data items, we are going to take constant amount of time, which is, let us say, order of one, right? In that case, we can say, let us make this tn is equal to 1. So what I mean to say is, if you have t of 1, then it will take order of 1 time only. Okay, that means you have only one data items. Fine. So this will become, let us make, let 2 raised to power k is equal to n. Hence we can say k log 2 base 2 is equal to log n base 2, which is equal to k is equal to log n base 2. Fine. Now put these values here, therefore you are going to get tn is equal to n t n upon my n plus this n into log n, hence which is equal to n t 1 plus n log n, which is again equal to n plus n log n. In both these two cases the leading term is n log n, hence the time complexity will be order of n log n. Hence, in case of best case, quicksort is going to take order of n log n time. Fine. So this is the best case when the partition is at the exact middle. So now let us see what will be the worst case for quicksort, and then what will the time complexity of quicksort in case whenever we are going to take worst case. Okay. Funny that in case of quicksort, if the data is already sorted, that means you got the data which is already sorted, then that data will take most amount of time or the maximum amount of time for quicksort to sort it. Okay. So what I mean to say is, let us suppose we are having these data items, which is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Okay. And we are going to apply quicksort in this. So assume the index locations are 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Fine. So initially apply quicksort A 1 comma 5. So partitioning, we are going to apply partitioning here. So this will be partition. So this will be pivot, and then we'll start I, and then we'll start J from here. As you can see, 1 is less than 5. We are going to increment the value of I. 1 will be swapped from 1, right? Then J will be incremented. Again, 2 is less than 5. Therefore, 2 will be swapped from 2. Again, we are going to increment the J. So 3 is less than 5. Therefore, 3 will be swapped from 3. again increment the value of j. 4 is less than 5, again increment the value of 5, I, therefore 4 will start with 5, and then increment the value of j. So 5 is less than equal to 5, therefore increment I and then swap it. So you can see 5 will be start with 5. Okay. So I've done it so many times that I actually remember all the procedure here. So what you can do is just take this item or take this data and try to sort it according to you. Okay. So in this case, we get I at the last index location. So you can say Q, the value of Q will become 5. Okay. Next time, if you are going to apply quick sort, then you are going to apply it A 1, 4. That means in this data item, or you are going to apply here quick sort A 6, 5. Again, this nothing will happen in this case. But here in this case, you can, if you apply quick sort again, then the partition will be from this case, then the value of Q will be 4 again. So next time we are going to apply it, then partition will be here. Again, next time you will apply, then partition will be here, somewhere here. Okay. So every time after partitioning, the left array will be this and right array, nothing will happen in this case. Fine. So in this case, if you are applying quick sort, then you can easily see what is happening here. The time taken to sort n data items will be equal to time taken to sort n minus 1 data items plus time taken to sort one data item plus order of n time for partitioning. That means this one data item is the right half in this case specifically. Okay. Now it will be equal to, you can see it is time taken to sort this data item will be n minus 1 plus n plus 1. Fine. Now if you solve this, you can find out it is Tn is equal to T of n minus 1 minus 1 plus n minus 1 plus n plus 1. Okay, so I just found the value of T of n minus 1. So this will be equal to T of n minus 2 plus n minus 1 plus n plus 1. Again, find the value of n minus 2, therefore it will be T of n minus 2 minus 1 plus n minus 2 plus n minus 1 plus n plus 1, which is equal to T of n minus 3 plus n minus 2 plus n minus 1 plus n plus 1. Fine. If you extend it till k, you can say find it is T of n minus k plus n minus k plus 1 plus n minus k plus 2 up to so on T of n minus which is equal to up to so on n minus 1 plus n plus 1. Fine. So let k is equal to n minus 1 because we want to make this value as 1, because we know if time taken to sort one data item will be 1 only, so we know this value. So let k is equal to n minus 1, therefore it will become T of 1 plus this will become 2 plus this will become 3 plus up to so on n minus 1 plus n plus 1. You can see this is the sum of first n terms of AP, or you can say first n natural numbers. Therefore this will be equal to n into n plus 1 by 2. I'm just ignoring this value because as you can see in case of time complexity, constants doesn't matter, so I could have ignored it here also. Fine. So this will be equal to order of n square. That means if you are doing quick sort and the data item is already sorted, either the data is sorted in increasing order or it is sorted in decreasing order, then quick sort will take maximum amount of time. Okay. So let us see if we have some data items are sorted, some data items are not sorted. Or you can say that if, let us suppose we have a partition, you can argue that if we have a partition and 90% data items will be at the first half or the second half, and then 10% will be at the second half, then what will be the time complexity of quicksort? So that is, in that case will be coming at the average case, right? So you can see in quicksort, in best case it is order of n square. So in best case it is order of n log n, in case of worst case it is order of n square, but in case of average case, quicksort will take order of n log n time. Why? Because if the case is like this, that means n minus 1 data items are here and one data item set, data item is at the next location, then it will take order of n square. But let us if 90% data items are here and 10% are at the next position, then it will again take order of
n log n time. So let me just prove it again. Fine.
Now let us say we have some data, and every time you are applying quick sort in the complete n data items, then in the first half we are getting 90% data, right? Or you can say it is 90/100, which is where 0 is cancelled by 0, therefore it will become 9/10. And then here we are going to get 10% data, 10% data, which will be equal to n/10, right? So in that case, what will be the time complexity, right? In that case, you can, sir, argue that, sir, if we have 90% data items in the first half, right, then we have to sort, next time we have to sort 90% data items here, we have to sort 10% data items, plus in partitioning we took this much amount of time, right? Fine. Now you can say to sort these many data items we have took, again in this case, again let us suppose in every case we are getting 90% data item at first location or the first half and 10% data items at the second half. In that case also the time taken will be t of 9 square n upon my 10 square, that is 90% data items at the first half and 10% data items is at the second half, plus time taken for partitioning, which is order of 9n/10. Okay. Now in this case also we can see, let us suppose 90% data items at the first half, that is t of time taken to sort 90% data items plus time taken to sort 10% data items plus time taken for partitioning. Okay. Again, you can extend this here. So this will become 90% data items in the first half, that is 9³ n/10³ plus 10% data item at the second half plus time taken to sort this. Fine. So why I am writing here is, so let us see, in this complete level what is the effort we have done, it is n, order of n, right? Now you can see in this complete level what is the amount of effort we have done. We have done this much effort here and this much effort here, so total effort will be only n, order of n. Now in this complete level you can see the effort we have done is order of n only, right? Now if you want to see what is the maximum effort we have done, we should know what is the height of the tree, because in every level, or you can say height of the tree, or you can say what are the number of levels, because in every level we are doing order of n time, n effort, fine. So what will be the maximum leading term which will go till the end, that will be this, because this is the maximum term in every case. So this will become up to t of 9 raised to power k n upon t is this much, 10 raised to power k. So here you can see, let 10 raised to power k, or you can say upon 9 raised to power k is equal to n, which is equal to, you can say 10 upon my 9 raised to power k is equal to n, take log on both the sides, so you will get k log 10/9 base 10/9 is equal to log n base 10/9. This will become 1, so it will be equal to k is equal to log n. Hence here you can see, to make this term as 1, we have to take up to log n height, right? So in every level we are doing order of n effort, and there will be log n levels, hence the total time which will be taken will be n log n, because we have n effort, log n effort, sorry, n effort, order of n effort at every level, and there will be log n levels total, so hence it will take order of n log n time, fine. So that means you can say easily that if we are doing quick sort, then even in the 90% data items at the one half and 10% the second half, then also we are going to take this much time, right? So this is the case of quick sort, and you can see by this, you can see what will be the average case. You have to take average of all the cases, and all the cases the average will be order of n log n time, fine. So in case of quick sort, let me just remind it again. So in case of best case, quick sort will take order of n log n time. In case of worst case, quicksort will take order of n square time. In case of average case, quicksort will take order of n log n time. Fine. As you can see, in the case of worst case, quicksort took order of n square time. Therefore, the question is, can we improve it? Can we do something better? Is there any algorithm or is there any changes in the quicksort which can make the time complexity in the worst case at order of n log n? Fine. And the answer is the randomized quicksort. So we have to study randomized quicksort to identify in worst case how quicksort is going to take order of n log n time, right? So that is, randomized quicksort is going to use the concept of randomization. That means we are going to choose a pivot element randomly in that case. Fine. So go through these videos again. If you have any doubt, email me. If you have any doubt, message me. I'm always there. Okay. So here a lot of people are here to answer you. All these people are experts. So just go through this everything again and let me know what you think about it. Fine. So let us go through the randomized quicksort now.